Do you believe that at this point there is a real possibility for a common understanding on the appreciation of the currency?
Well, I think it's unambiguous. China's decided they need to let the exchange rate start to reflect market forces again, to rise in response to market forces. They're letting that happen. That's in China's interest to do. They're moving very gradually because they want to be careful how they do this.
Up 5% since June.
Yeah, about 5% since June against the dollar.
Right.
But if you adjust for the fact that inflation in China is substantially higher than the United States, in real terms, which is what matters for competitiveness, for the incentives people have about where they invest, where they build something, it's appreciating substantially more rapidly against the dollar, probably about 10% a year. And of course, that's likely to continue because it's necessary for China, so they can reinforce the strategy of moving away from exports to domestic demand and help contain the inflation pressures they see.
Can they do that without having to worry about losing jobs because of the export demand?
Well, one reason they're moving carefully, gradually, is they want to make sure that they don't undermine the capacity of the country to grow going forward. But so far, and I think this is very encouraging, you're seeing Chinese growth look very strong, really very resilient. And I think certainly from our perspective, the Chinese economy is certainly in a position where it's strong enough it can withstand the pressures that come with letting your currency rise. But I think you should look at the other way. If they don't allow it to rise, then again, the risk is that China would face higher risk of inflation going forward. But, you know, I think the leadership of China has a very sophisticated understanding of how to balance those forces. And I think they're moving in the right direction now. Of course, we'd like to see them move more rapidly, as with much of the rest of the world. And, you know, they'll come to the right judgment.
So do you think the arguments do resonate with them?
Oh, absolutely they do. That's why they're moving. Because, again, China recognized it was in their interest to move. And, you know, I think you'll likely see that continue.
It is said that you were very much bothered by the U.S. economy coming out of the crisis. China was the first to recover. Do you have great concerns about the American economy?
Actually, the numbers for the American economy in the fourth quarter of last year were quite good. And in the first quarter of this year, your jobs market is improving, and we have seen good numbers about the economic growth in the first quarter. It may not be that satisfactory, but it was not bad. And talking about the American economy, I believe the housing market is the most important thing for the American economy. And this issue has not been fully addressed in the course of the financial crisis. And the housing problems are correlated with the jobs market, and I still foresee possible problems in this area. The policy of quantitative easing in the United States has brought back some confidence in the U.S. capital market, and that in turn has created some wealth returns, which has as a result boosted part of your domestic demand, and this is good also for the jobs. But still, I believe housing is a big issue we have to take seriously, and it has not been fully addressed.
Secretary Geithner has expressed what he would like to see happen with respect to the currency. What would you like to see from Secretary Geithner?
First and foremost, I believe what is important for the United States to do is to depoliticize economic issues with China. During my previous conversations with Secretary Geithner, I often told him that it was true that there was always a political dimension to economic problems, and economic issues are closely related to political ones. But it is dangerous to politicize economic issues. Take the exchange rate, a very simple issue, as an example. It seems to me that somehow the Americans have a view believing that China's trade surplus was all caused by the manipulation of its exchange rate. And China became a big trading country in the world simply by manipulating its currencies. Actually, this is a very politicized argument. And for all those people who really understand what the exchange rate is really about, they would not say so.
Join us online at charlierose.com.